Oh, it's so soft. It smells so good. Totally worth the $1,000 I spent. Good morning, guys, or good afternoon. It might be noon o'clock. Happy Friday. Hope everybody had an awesome Friday. Today is November 3rd? What day is it today? Let me look at my new calendar. Let's see, this is cut. Today's November 4th. Happy November 4th. And I'm doing this follow-up video to the Timeless Organic Skincare. I've been using this for, let's see, either 1 week or 2 weeks. I can't remember, but I've been using it for a while. And I'm just gonna come on here and do a follow-up video to show you guys how much I like it, if I'm noticing changes. So before I even get started, let me just do a little bit of a review. Timeless Organic Skincare, basically. I saw them on Facebook because my cousin shared a post about them. She was talking about, oh my gosh, how much they work. And I was like, oh, I'm looking for some new skincare products, so maybe I'll try that. So I went to their website. They have this three-step acne system, which you get these tiny little bottles. They're like 4 ounces each. Tiny little bottles. Tiny little bottles for 4 ounces each for, I think, this set together. I don't want to say it was 36. That's too much money. It was not 40 bucks for this. It was, I think, 26. It was still expensive. And can't think of your name, but somebody told me, why not just buy them separate? You know, like, I think I might have hinted that each one is maybe about $10. But here's why you can't just buy them separate. Because first of all, when I went on the website, I didn't even see them separate. Like, I don't think she sells them separate. And if they do, I think the spray, or was it the lotion? Something, I think I saw it was maybe $12. So you see how even if I could buy them separate, they'd be like, they'd equal up to 26 anyway. Cause sometimes for the stuff that works, that good organic stuff, you guys just pay more. So, you know. The skincare system was about $26. And then I also got this African black soap. It looks like this. I've been using it for a few weeks now. This was $7. Oh, it smells good. It smells so natural. So what I've been doing is I'll use the three-step acne system in the morning, and then when I come home from school or in the middle of the day, I use the African black soap, and then I'll do the skincare system again at night. I tried to do that. One day I went to bed without doing the skincare system. One day I came home from school, I didn't use the black soap. So for the first week or so, maybe even week and a half, I was real good. I was doing this in the morning, soap in the afternoon, this again at night. I was like, I was on it. Kind of fell off with it a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna try to get back on that. But as you saw in the beginning, I just washed my face with the acne system. Skin is so smooth. Like, after you use this stuff, you're just gonna feel like touching your skin. And it's gonna be like, oh my gosh, it feels so amazing. And it smells really good too. She uses like organic ingredients. If you look on the ingredients, I'm just gonna read a few of them, like distilled water, apple cider vinegar, Australian tea tree oil, lavender oil, myrrh oil, frankincense. I got on my face with baby Jesus head from the wise men. What you just looked at, frankincense and myrrh. Oh my goodness, this is amazing. So I took a before picture. I think you guys remember that in my first video. I took a before picture, like, we're gonna look at it now. And if I can go get my phone, which is right here conveniently, let me take an after picture, because I'm not sure if you guys can tell. My dad said he could kind of tell. Just being honest, I can't really tell. I'm not really seeing a huge difference. Sometimes it takes, you know, like a good month or two for the dark marks to really go away. I'm not really seeing a lot. I know these three dark marks right here seem to be lightening up, but I had this acne right here, okay? Like, it showed all in my Snapchat videos, and I was like, oh my gosh, right here. But I can't blame the skincare for this, okay? Because if you guys look right over here, somehow I got this bowl of candy on my desk. Now, how did this bowl of candy just get on my desk? Like, how does this happen? And Ethan came in here and just devoured it yesterday. Like, I told him he could get one chocolate bar because he was acting up, and somehow he got three on his bed. Like, I'm like, really? You act like you don't get the most candy out of anybody in this house. But it was just Halloween. Look at that candy I got. I don't know how it got there, but I had that candy. Then, you know, my professor's stressing me out, so it's probably like stress knee. And then instead of drinking water, which I should be drinking water, I've been drinking those juices and stuff, and I'm going to Taco Bell today. So when you're trying to clear up your skin, it's not just what you smack on your skin. You also have to like drink water and make sure you're eating right, because that can play a part in your skin. So that's why I can't blame this. I feel as though it is working, but you know, I gotta fix my diet a little bit. Well, speaking of diet, I gotta tell y'all what I'm doing for January. But anyways, let's take a picture so we can look at before and after. Okay, jeez. All right. Wow, that could have been a good picture if it just wasn't pink. Dang, this case, it just, jeez. Cheese again. I just realized, oh, I look creepy. And I just realized, Okay, so looking at the before and after pictures, I can see a little bit of a difference. Ever so slightly. You see, I would put a before and after in this video, but these pictures do look kind of weird, so it's like, I don't know, I'm a little embarrassed. But I am seeing my skin lighten up a little bit. I still got my signature dark marks, so it might take a little bit longer. And like I said, it's not all the skincare products' fault. I haven't been drinking a lot of water and sugary snacks and candy, so I would recommend it. I really would recommend it. It smells really nice. The only thing I don't like is I wish she would give you more. But 4 ounces? Can't you just add on a few more ounces? Like, instead of this little bottle, can the bottle be like this tall or something? Like, just some more of it, which I saw with some complaints like elsewhere. You know, they just wanted more of the product. But let's see how much I've used. Like, I really don't even think, even though it is a little bit, it's like right here. That's how much I've used of it in a few weeks. So I think this might last me a good amount, but after I use this up, I don't think I'm gonna buy any more, but I still want to buy from their website, even though it's expensive stuff. I still want more, so I might get their morning scrub and their evening scrub, because they have like facial scrubs, so I might do that instead. Mom keeps saying that I don't even need to buy all these products for my face. All I need to do is, you know, go to Dollar Tree and get the soap. But I was like, Mom, but that Dollar Tree soap doesn't make my skin smell excellent and make it feel smooth. So I don't think I did this in the last video, but I'll link their Facebook page or their website down below. So if you guys want to go get some skincare products, you can go get it. Just make sure you save up some money to go get it, because it can get kind of pricey. And that is my update on the skincare products. Now, before I wrap this video up, I did want to tell you guys something about this diet I'm doing in January. I was thinking I should have told you guys maybe on New Year's Eve, but I'm just going to tell you now, because my mom just told me about it. So basically, my mom is doing this challenge with her friend, and my mom asked me that I want to do it, and I said, Mom, it's going to be crazy, but I think I might actually try and do it. It's called the No Grain Challenge. And my mom said it's not really a diet, so I'm trying not to call it that, even though it seems like it's a diet, but she said it's not a diet. It's more like a lifestyle change, you know, just changing what you eat. And it's gonna be hard, but my mom said something about grains and how if you eat too many grains, how it's not good for you. I think mom's trying to limit her grains, but you know, too much of a good thing is never good. I know what you dietitians out there are saying, but what about brown rice cereal? Brown rice is good for you. That's what my friend says. She wants to be a dietitian. And I was like, yeah, but something about too many grains, like they're not exactly good for you. I can't remember exactly what my mom said, but it is an issue with brown rice. So for the first month, which is January, we're gonna eat no grains. And then February, March, April, you know, we can start eating more grains. Just the goal is to limit them. So in January, that would be no bread, which I don't eat a lot of bread anyway. I'm not a sandwich eater. Like, I just discovered that about myself. Like, I don't eat Subway. Like, the last time I had Subway was maybe a few months ago. I don't eat Subway. I don't eat sandwiches. That's just not my thing. So no bread, no rice, no, it's gonna be no Taco Bell for me. Which I know what some of y'all are thinking, Alexis, you can't do it, but you know what, I'm gonna try. No Taco Bell, because the chips is corn and wheat, and like the tortilla is made of like the wheat and stuff, so it's like no Taco Bell. No pasta, so that's no mac and cheese. No mac and cheese, no spaghetti, no lasagnas. So I have to try that. No like dinner rolls and stuff. I said no bread. No couscous, because I don't need a lot of that anyway. And it was no something else. I said no rice. Basically anything that has that grain in it, it's none of it. And the health effects of that, like when you cut back your grains, it's supposed to... what is that supposed to... I forgot what my mom told me. So this is why I should have waited. But I'm just telling you guys that I'm going to try and do that starting January 1st. And you know, if any of you guys want to try it with me, you never know. We could lose 10 pounds the month of January. Like, would you look at that? I'm going to try. Like, for real, no Taco Bell. I'm looking at this school and I said, you know what, I'm going to this school. When I graduate community college, I'm going here. They got a Taco Bell on campus. It's going to be tough, but I'm going to try it. January, my birthday month, it's going to be so hard, but all right. I told you guys how the skincare thing works. My skin is still feeling soft, even though I've been sitting here talking to this video, I mean, talking to this camera for a minute. Skin's still feeling soft. I told you guys about what I'm doing for January, so I'm going to wrap this video up right here because I got a lot of homework to go do. My professor's getting kind of crazy. Like, bro, they're rushing towards the end of the semester. I don't get this. But, okay, let me wrap this video up. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do that. Thumbs this video up. And I'll talk to you guys another day. Bye-bye.